today I'm here with a new video, and today I have a guest with me, and this is Jessica.
Hey.
Do you want to introduce yourself?
Hello! I also have a channel.
Yes, I will leave her channel up here.
Are we sure it's
yeah,
up there?
Yeah, I think it's up there.
Okay, we don't take that discussion.
I should know this because this is my camera.
Yeah.
Yeah, it should be up here. So okay. If the lighting is a little bit like it not usually is.
Or if I'm blurry.
Yeah, because we can't see shit if it's
no
focus or not. So, okay, we have done a video on Jessica's channel. So if you want to be like, watch a video in for 2 hours, you can go over and watch
it. I will try to edit it, but I don't think I will do much to it.
We had fun at least.
Mm.
You maybe don't have to look at it straight like 2 hours.
We won't take offense if you speed it up.
No. Please do. Or slow it down. I think that will be fun. I think we should sound drunk.
I'm okay. So concentrated on sitting still.
Shh.
Det är Angelica.
Okay. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So, yes, we are going to do a tag video.
Woohoo!
Woohoo! And this is indie makeup brand.
No.
Fan, jag är så dålig på det här. The indie makeup tag.
It's 3 words.
Yeah, it's hard. This was created by Millie, Badtothebrow. I will leave her up there.
Okay.
Home, it's up there, so it should be up there.
It just feels weird when you're pointing at my head.
Up here. And down in the description, and I will also leave the questions. So this is 9 questions, and Jessica is much more prepared than I am.
Maybe.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah.
And if you hear someone making noises, it's Gumball.
It's my boyfriend.
Okay.
It's Gumball.
It's Gumball. He has come home.
Yeah. And me and Gumball are friends.
Yes.
I think.
And you are friends with my dad.
Yeah, I talked to her dad and your mom.
And my brother.
Yeah, and your brother.
Welcome.
Because we established on Jessica's channel that we are sisters.
If okay. You didn't know.
Okay, we are recorded for like 5 minutes and then haven't started with the first question, so
it will still be shorter.
Yeah, clip out.
Okay.
It's going to be a pain in the ass to edit. It feels like when I'm alone, I'm much more controlled.
Yes.
Yeah.
I don't laugh at myself.
I do. But I cut it out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Keep it.
Clip out. Okay, I have to unbutton my...
If you want to know what that means, you have to go watch.
Yeah, we said it in like after 1 hour, 40 minutes. So.
Don't tell them where it is. Okay, question number one.
Should I read the question?
Yes.
Okay. Because it's my channel.
Yes, yeah, okay. And I don't have...
I only have the answers. Read here.
No,
if I read the questions, you read. Okay. Question number one. I always say 9 when I'm doing this. So I just have to take it over once more. Okay. Question number one. What does indie mean to you in terms of handmade, private label, and independent owned?
Are we going to have the same discussion we had before?
We discussed this and then we was like, maybe we should start recording that. Okay, what do we think? I'm a little bit torn about this.
Yes.
I think it's hard to answer.
Yeah, because you know that there is a definition about what is indie. And I don't have the same.
No. For like example, we talked before about Fenty Beauty. That is an indie brand because it's independently owned.
Mm.
But I think somehow it's too big.
Yes, it doesn't feel like, because everyone knows about Fenty.
Yeah.
And I don't count, in my head, I don't count like Dose of Colors or Jeffree Star. And I think UVS Place is...
But I think I count Jeffree Star as an indie brand.
But you can, if you want to.
Oh, I can!
But when we are doing the rest of the questions, I don't count in Jeffree Star.
Okay.
So you know.
But I think that Jeffree Star should be considered an indie brand because he... Okay, how should I put this? I'm so good with words.
Okay.
Like, he is the face of the brand.
Yes.
He is like his own brand. with Fenty, I don't think about Rihanna, but with Jeffree Star, I think about only Jeffree Star. And he's talking and promoting his own products.
And now I want to think of a brand that does that, that is not indie, but I can't think.
Yeah, exactly.
And so you think Kat Von D also is...
an indie brand, yeah. Mm-hmm. And Linda Hallberg, she's talks about her own brand.
Yes.
And like Makeup Addiction, she talks about her own brand.
Yes. And Makeup Geek.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't agree.
You don't have to, but that's what I think.
Yeah. And it's kind of also how many people that are involved in the process, because Jeffree Star has a factory and a crew and everything.
Yeah, but he still feels... okay, now I'm like defending Jeffree Star.
But like Blush Tribe or Certified, they are only one or two people.
Yeah.
So I will not count in those brands, I'm just saying.
But do you count like a private label brand as an indie brand? I don't, because no. They just buy like a finished thing.
Yes. I don't think I would count that, but I can't think of a good example. So, yeah, we have different opinions.
Yeah. Mm. And I don't know if you came to any conclusion, but that's the...
we came to the conclusion that we don't agree.
Yeah, and did you see we have recorded for like 8 minutes?
Yeah, I'm not question. Surprised.
This is going to be less than 2 hours. Maybe not.
Maybe. Okay.
Okay. Question number two.
Yes.
Should we read the like varannan ord?
Okay.
What?
Jag säger
inte. No, okay, I think. What are your top three favorite indie brands?
You can start with one.
Okay.
I decide.
Yeah. Can we take the same? Yeah, of course. Yes. Can we are not the same person. It's like it's in school and like you can't say
you can't pick mine.
No. I can start with Linda Hallberg.
Oh. I want to have that too, but yeah, I don't have it on my list. I take Blush Tribe.
And then I take Menagerie, I think.
Then I take Certify.
And then for my last one... I say Nabla. Okay. I love their lipsticks. But I don't know if that's my top three. But for now. Okay. For this moment.
This second.
So.
And since I'm not counting in Jeffree Star, and I have decided not to count UVS Place, let's decide that. Then I'm saying Melt.
I don't think it's them as an indie brand.
I do. Do you? But I don't know.
It must be an indie brand.
Yeah, there are two people. Let's say they are an indie brand.
I don't think that I'm so like into Melt because it was so hard to get Melt to Sweden before. So I was like, I'm not going to care a shit about that brand.
No. But they have such good customer service, so I like them.
That's the only thing you like?
No. But that makes up for it's
being
hard.
Hard, yeah.
Yes.
This is good. It feels like all our energy went to your video.
Yes.
We were so sweaty.
Yeah. It's so warm.
Yeah, and my eyes keep on rinning.
Rinning? Is it called that?
No.
And I can't see. Oh my god!
I don't see that eye. I only see this eye.
I'm so sorry.
Maybe we should like do this.
You have to put in something that covers your eye.
What do you want?
A star.
A star, yeah. Mm. I put in a star there on your little eye. Which indie brand has disappointed you and why? And you have an answer to this because I don't know if I have.
I have a lot of brands.
Just spill the tea.
But the reason I
don't know if I'm going to look in the camera and looking at you, it feels...
because I never look in the camera. But when I look in the viewfinder here, it looks like I'm looking more into the camera.
Yeah, I have never figured this out. And I know that people hate that you look in the viewfinder, but sometimes when I look into the lens, I look like cross-eyed or something.
Yeah, because it looks like we're looking... I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know.
I can look there.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
But I have a lot of brands that have disappointed me, but it's more like their customer service that has disappointed me.
Maybe then I have some brands. But you can take your brands and I can just come with my...
And the reason that most of these brands have disappointed me are that they answer in a very unprofessional way. And it's very hard to get your money back even if you didn't get the products. To give a short
explanation. But are we only to spill something?
Maybe.
Maybe.
But I can say the brands I'm thinking of is... Pinky Rose. Bombshell Cosmetica, I will not buy from them.
They are the one with like that.
Yes. Yeah. It took 2.5 months to get those.
Yeah.
Yep. And Blush Tribe sometimes. And Love Lux Beauty, I will never buy from them again. And Menagerie Cosmetics sometimes. And
that was a lot.
Yes, and there is probably more. But I'm so sensitive to if you have bad customer service. If I would have counted every star, I would have taken him with me.
In this.
Down.
Down.
But like Love Lux Beauty, everything came broken and they were so rude when they answered me.
I feel that it's more important for smaller brands, yes, and especially indie brands, to be nice to the customers.
Yes.
Because they only can rely on... Yeah. Everybody relies on customers, but like small indie brands, they don't have like commercials or they don't have any other store that promote them.
No.
So the only one that promote them is the customers. And if they are rude to customers...
And you take a chance when you buy from them.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's not cheap either.
And especially from Sweden?
Yeah, usually the shipping is higher from when you buy indie brands.
Yeah.
So, and that's usually why I'm disappointed in them. It can take time, it usually do, but if you write like it's my fault, then I get annoyed.
I understand it.
Yes. It not be a negative video.
No, we should be happy.
Okay, did you have some brands?
No.
Happy for you.
Happy for me. No, I maybe think that I have a little bit of I don't try to talk about drama on my channel or like stuff like that because it just takes my energy.
Yeah.
So I just don't care instead.
That's good.
Yeah, that's good.
Oy. Oops.
I'm going to fix
yeah.
Just spill some water.
Not tea.
Not tea. Okay, so where were we?
You were talking about
Blush Tribe. I was going to say, I don't know if I mentioned it.
No.
No.
Okay.
Okay. I think that the owner of... Okay, I don't want to like throw somebody under the bus.
Okay, but some indie brands.
Some indie brands and their owners should be better to take criticism and critique from normal people. Like the normal customer, not like a bigger people.
Not from the
normal, yeah. But I was like thinking about if they send out like PR package to YouTubers. It feels like we have been drinking wine or something.
Yeah, yeah. Just water.
Yeah, and Pepsi
Max.
Yeah, Pepsi Max.
Some owners.
Yeah. They have to be able to take criticism, and I think that is a big problem. Not a big problem, but that is a problem inside of the smaller indie brand community. It feels like most of the owners, some of the owners, take all the criticism personally when it's regarding the brand and not them as a person, like a private person. And
they should have separate Instagram accounts.
Yeah. And I think one bigger indie brand that really has a problem with this, or had, is Jeffree Star.
Yes.
Yes. I think if he handled things better privately, it would be better for the brand.
Yeah. But he doesn't put up things on his his brand's
no.
Instagram.
No, he does not.
No.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Yeah. I hope you get something out of this.
I think they get more out of this than the other video.
Maybe. Should we do the snail and the car in this video as well?
Yes.
Yeah.
You will. No, lightning.
Lightning ball.
Yes.
Yeah, but it's my channel. I want the car.
Okay. You won't get any cars.
Because nobody going to speed it. Okay, I'm not going to tell you what we're talking about.
Nope.
Nope. Okay, question number 4.
Yes.
Which indie brands have you not tried yet that you really want to try? And I really want to try Lethal Cosmetics. It feels like I have talked about them in so many videos, but I really, really, really want to try them.
Why didn't you use them today?
I don't know.
I have used mine, so you could have used it.
And that you say now?
No, I said it before.
Yeah, okay. But I said...
She's coming here and she's using her own makeup.
Yeah, and I'm coming here and she's using my makeup.
Yeah.
Yeah. And my brushes.
Yeah, never mind.
Yeah. Lethal I want to try.
Yeah.
And then I think I want to try Divina Cosmetics.
Yeah. They are also on my list, but I forgot to write them down. And Nabla.
Nabla.
And Luxie. And JD Glow. They are called that, right?
Yeah.
JD Glow.
The Juicy Olives. Is that JD Glow?
No, that's Gimme Glow.
I always
they
mix
are
them
also
up.
On.
Yeah.
And Max Up the Make. Is it called that?
I don't know.
You know the Flower Child Palette? Or was it called? I don't have it, so obviously, yeah. Because I have not tried it.
Yeah, but you can have it, but you haven't tried it.
Oh, then there is a lot. But you know the one that also has a summer palette with water?
I will leave the name here.
I think no. It's called Max
Up. She's going
Up
to Google it,
it,
because yes. She doesn't trust me.
No.
Do you have any
you don't know what I'm talking about.
Do you have any other code words than keep out? Like, keep in?
Keep in. Keep in. Da.
Yeah, I know which one. Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah.
Mm. And Alien Cosmetics.
Yeah, Alien. They have pretty fun things.
Mm. But it's the shipping.
Yeah, I think with all the brands I want to try, I'm
it's just
ship.
One brand.
And that's not even in the US.
No.
But I also want to try Pink Rose.
Yeah, okay, I also want to try Pink Rose, but I have their palette.
But a lot of me is the shipping.
Yes.
And with Lethal, I only have one problem. I don't want that white palette.
No, but they have the black one now.
No.
Yes.
No.
What? No.
It's out of stock.
But I was in there trying to order another one, but I stopped myself. And they had a black one.
No. I'm on here like every day.
You know you can put them in another palette if you want.
It's out of stock.
But when you do your own palette, it doesn't say that it's out of stock.
Yeah, but it's out of stock. I've asked them. I'm that annoying woman asking.
And what did they answer?
Yeah, it will come in 4 weeks.
Oh my god.
Yeah, oh my god, I know.
I didn't want a white palette either, but I didn't want to wait.
Yeah, but I can't stand that white palette.
But you know you can use some.
Yeah, but I...
If you turn it around, there's it's a black sticker.
Black sticker is not the
you
same.
You got the black sticker with.
No. No.
But it's easy to
but like clean. Here, in about 4 weeks. They yeah. said 3 weeks ago, so... Guess who's getting ooh. A palette back next week?
I will order... Apparently they have... There is... Is there 12 shades in that palette?
Yes.
I think we can check. But yeah.
Yeah, I know that I like yes.
And I think they have like, so you can fill 2 palettes and then they only have like 4 shades. So you can't get 3 palettes.
Oh.
Just so you know.
Okay, which question was that?
We have number 5 now.
Yeah. Question number 5. If you could own an entire product collection from one brand, what brand would it be? And this was so hard because first I was like Linda Hallberg and then I was like, I own everything from
yeah,
Linda Hallberg.
Yeah, I was thinking that as well, like, oh that, oh, but I already have everything. But I come up with 2 things.
I think I would like to own everything from Menagerie Cosmetics. Only palettes.
And you don't do that?
No.
You don't? No? Okay.
I don't have the courtship palette. I don't have all the lipsticks.
It feels like I judged you. Yeah.
I only have 70 palettes.
Okay.
And also maybe... I want to... I was going to say Nabla, but they have Hubbard.
I want the Cleonard stained glass collection.
Is it that one that is like...
Pretty.
Yeah. All the other things are ugly.
And I want all the single shadows from JD Glow.
You...
All the other things are already...
You are so much more prepared than I am.
You send this on Monday, so... Or something like that.
Yeah, but I am on... I have vacation, so...
You have a lot more time than me.
I have done things.
But if I wouldn't have the things I have, I would have wanted the blush tri palettes.
All the blush tri palettes.
But I already have them.
Do you have all?
Yes.
Do you have the mean ones?
Yes. It's over there.
Okay. Okay. I sounded like that meme.
Okay. The only one I don't have, but I can order it if I want to, is the... Layla? I don't know if you pronounce it like that. Because it's
Layla.
Layla. Because it's a mix of the palettes I already have.
Is it Hasina?
Hasina one.
And Blossom?
Blossom, Munasa, and Hasina.
Okay.
So I have ordered the Pastel Tribe and the Layla too.
Ooh. Okay, next question maybe.
Yes.
Are you satisfied with your answer?
Question number 6.
Question number 6 is good that you are keeping track because I'm not.
Yeah, but I see what I have answered.
Yeah, okay, you're smart. I can't see what I have read.
Thank you.
Question number 6. What unique product and or concept have indie companies brought to the table that big brands have not? And I have to say color.
Yes.
Color, color, color.
Yeah, and it's a weird question because now all the big brands have copied, so they bring out more color, but indie brands are more like just color and monochromatic.
Yeah, exactly. I think that like ColourPop, they are an indie brand, but they are so big.
Yeah,
but they do like the monochromatic palettes, and maybe if say Anastasia comes out with a more colorful palette, it's still like a normal palette and a colorful palette all at once. And I get why they do that, because they want to sell it. Yeah.
But even Blush Tribe, the most neutral palettes they have are still colorful.
Yeah.
So, what did I write? And they are very quick, yeah. I wrote written that down as well.
Yes, the indie brands are.
Yeah, they are much more quick to come out with stuff.
Yeah, and it feels like we're not in focus right now. Where are we?
Here.
I'm so sorry if this is out of focus, but it doesn't look to be too much out of focus.
Don't you have a program that can fix that? No.
Maybe I have, but I don't know.
I don't have.
I don't know how.
You just taught me how to fix the battery for my own camera. Yeah. So.
But that has nothing with editing to do.
No.
Okay, question number 7.
Yes.
What are your 3 favorite products that you own from indie brands? And I think I should have wrote something down for this.
I have.
Yeah, and I can't look.
No. I can start.
Or? Is it like one single product?
Yes, I decide.
Decide.
I have 3 palettes.
Okay. Will you take it first or should I try to... Should I try to do mine?
Okay, but I just want to have on record that I have already written down my answer, so I won't copy you.
Okay. First out, I would say this is a boring palette, but I love that palette, and that is the Infinite palette from Lena Hallberg. Love that, can use it for like everything.
Yes.
And then the lipstick I am wearing is one of my favorite lipsticks ever, and that is Hanging Rock from Nabla. And the third thing,
I don't think we will have the same. But I'm not going to show you.
You're so supportive. I think it's hard when you're going to pick out like favorites, because right now, maybe one of my new palettes are like a favorite for right now because it's new.
Yeah, but like if you could only save three things.
I would save two of my cats and my boyfriend.
No, I wouldn't say
your creepy cute palette. Yeah, my creepy cute palette.
You're welcome.
Thank you, my creepy cute palette.
I just saw it. Okay, I have my three things. The Paulina palette.
Of course.
Yes, that's one of my favorites.
Mm-hmm.
And from Blush Tribe. And the Tropical Wonders palette. I have Certified. Two from Certified.
You have two?
Yeah, because that one looks like a mess because the black is broken, so I got a new one.
Okay, yeah.
Very useful. And
it was the hardest, like, ever.
And the last thing is the Radioactive Stack from Melt.
You love that so much.
I think I don't have any shades that are as good as
that
like one.
I like the questioning about you about that.
Yeah, okay.
You like that one.
I don't have any neon shades that are as good as they are, but I don't use it that often. But
no, me neither.
But it's very unique because I don't have anything that is as good as that.
Well, that's pretty good choices.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
And you also have good choices because I picked one.
Yeah, thank you.
And I also like the Kaleidos, but I have not used them that much. So.
Oh, I love them. Why didn't I think of them?
Because you didn't prepare. You can just look around. They are over there.
Which one is your favorite?
I have only used one.
Wait, which one have you used?
The one with the red nib. Keep it.
The bronze one?
Yeah, I think so. And I used that in a video where I speed everything up. Like a quick get ready. Okay. So
okay.
Good story.
I love the sci-fi green for some reason because I always say like I don't like green.
You don't like purple either.
No, but I don't like purple.
Okay.
I think I look even more pale in purple. I don't know how that's possible, but every time I do like a purple lip, I'm like, ooh.
I think I do that with blue.
Yeah.
I look like I've been out in the cold. But yeah, I don't remember what we were talking about.
Nah, okay, we were answering a question that was had nothing to do about.
We can add that in. Okay,
eight. If you could collaborate with one in the brand, which one would it be and what would you create?
Easy.
Is it easy for you?
An eyeshadow palette?
Yeah, eyeshadow palette was my brand.
Yeah.
Okay.
Do you want to think about the brands?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep. Do you want to answer?
Okay.
Or should we wait for my brain to work
again? I can answer.
Yeah, answer then.
I would love to do...
Blush.
I was thinking of that from the beginning, but I crossed it out.
Oh.
Because I think a lot of people have done collabs. I would love to do a palette with Melt, because I like their formula. Or a stack. I think I would like to do a stack. Like the one with the double. That's not how you do double.
The double!
With the duos.
The double!
The double. But then at the same time, I really want to do a lot of shades. So either a Melt stack or a Certified palette.
What do you want to put in your palette?
Eyeshadow.
Yeah, okay!
Kind! I would do a rainbow palette, but with more... you know, one not one green, like a dark green, a light green, a shimmer green, and so on. You look confused.
No, that sounds great.
Okay. Because I would want to have a palette that is like that. Because usually rainbow palettes aren't like that.
No. I would like to do like a grungy palette.
Oh.
And I want to do both matte and shimmers.
Yes.
Because it feels often when it's a grungy palette, it's only matte shades.
Yes.
And then when they want to spice it up with shimmer, they take like a gold or something. But I would like a mustard.
Yeah, I was just going to say a shimmery mustard.
Yeah.
Oh.
And like it, this
foresty.
Yeah, dark this military green. Yes. Yeah, and then shimmer.
And so dark red.
Yeah. I would like to do.
Yes.
Like you compare them, so you have one shimmer and one matte, and then in grungy.
A dirty rainbow.
Yeah.
Oh, a dirty rainbow. But just don't steal that name.
But this is my channel, so I can just cut it out and then I say, oh, and the name should be Dirty Rainbow.
I would be happy if someone stole my ID, because then I would have that palette.
But I don't know which brand I would like to do it with.
Menagerie Cosmetics.
Yeah, but they don't feel like they do like crunchy stuff.
Okay.
Not like a whole grungy. Want something melt. Cooler? Yeah,
Oh, damn.
Yeah, maybe melt.
No. Strobe Cosmetics can do it.
Yeah, Strobe, they need.
Yeah,
we
they only
Strobe.
Have two.
Yeah, so the creepy cute.
Yeah, and then
the dirty rainbow.
Yeah.
So Strobe, you can hit us up.
It was my idea.
Yeah, but my color story and her name. My info is down below. They're like, what the hell?
No, we just take the ID. One question left.
One question left. Question number 9. What is one thing you wish indie brands did more of? I would like them to do more face products.
Highlighter, bronzer, blush.
Duos.
Duos.
I think the most indie brands often like concentrate to eyeshadows.
Yes.
And sometimes highlighters.
Yes, sometimes.
But I would like them to do other face stuff. I understand that it's hard to do like a foundation because you need to do so many foundations.
Yes.
But like maybe a setting spray, because I love setting spray. Or maybe mascaras.
Oh, I think that is so. It's like when I hear, oh, they released foundation, I'm like, oh.
Yeah, usually me too, because I am to pay for everything.
Yes. But, oh, no, I think that is so boring. Oh, I would love more blushes and bronzers in pretty packaging. Yes.
So that I think we should do more of. That was
I'm just like, no mascara.
But like, ColourPop is like the only one that have all super really colorful mascaras.
Yes.
Yes. I wish that more brands would do that.
Yes.
But I don't know if mascara is a hard thing to do.
No, but I just think that they think that it won't sell.
But I won't buy it.
Yes, I bought all the ColourPop ones.
I want to buy it!
I have all of them except the brown.
Oh, this feels boring.
Yeah, I will never use the brown. But I think it's worth it, because if you don't use them often enough, it doesn't matter, because they were so cheap.
If they should do like Minis.
Yes.
Of colorful.
Do Minis ColourPop.
Do Minis.
Oh, like if they're watching. If some of you know ColourPop, please tell them to do
Minis. Tell them to do Minis.
Yes.
I think that more brands should do Minis.
Yes. But I would buy them.
I don't know if it's more expensive to do Minis.
Yeah, it's more expensive to buy them if you calculate.
Yeah.
The stuff.
The calculating. He works at the bank over
yeah,
there.
That's how we do it.
You want to take a mortgage?
I have a calculator. Mortgage. Mortgage.
Mortgage.
Mortgage.
It sounds like a morgue.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. So I always say, pay back on the loan instead.
So they don't think you're talking about that people?
Or mortgage.
Mortgage.
Mortgage. What did you say? Mortgage.
Mortgage. You know the loan? The mortgage.
Mortgage. No. Funny.
Funny. If you...
Good stuff.
Good stuff. Making content. This is like the first video ever on my channel.
I was going to say no, the other one, but that won't be up on your
channel. No, it won't. She wanted to switch the videos when we were at like 2 hours on the other one.
Yes.
But think of all the money if somebody watched that one.
Well, It's if they watch the commercial.
Yeah, I can watch it. Do you give me some? Do I get a percentage of the money if that video?
No. If I get a percentage of the dirty rainbow.
Yeah, you can get some money for that. Okay.
That was all the questions.
Yes. Whoa! Super fun video.
I thought it was going to be shorter. But yeah, I think too. It's an half an hour at least. How many times have you?
I don't know. It was not a good one.
No. Yeah, it was.
Yeah, it was.
Do you have an outro?
Yeah. I'm just like, bye!
Please subscribe!
Yes, sometimes I do it. But yeah, I will leave Jessica's channel on her face.
Thank you.
Thank you! And down in the description.
Yeah.
And also our video.
Don't watch my video after this. Take a nap before.
Yeah. Be prepared.
It's for a long video. Yeah. We filmed for 2 hours and...
But we had fun.
Yeah, it was really
fun. At least
fun.
We two had fun. Yeah. I don't think anybody else would think it's fun.
But at least we didn't talk that much Swedish.
No.
I thought we were going to talk more Swedish.
Yeah.
Because it's weird talking English to someone that knows Swedish.
Yes. Our, like, backup plan was to do the video in Swedish and then put subtitles in it.
It almost became that because it took a lot of time before we were able to record the first video. It was like so uncomfortable.
But it felt better now.
Yes.
Or did it? Okay, okay. We finished?
Yes.
So now we're going to say goodbye.
Okay.
Okay, and it sounds like I'm a teacher. So you take off the... But I can't not do this anymore. I have done it in all my videos. I can't stop now.
Okay. You do, you do.
Or should I do yours? Goodbye!
Yours!
You wanted an outro and I gave you one.
Yeah, but you are not here to do that for me because I couldn't reach the camera.
You can have like a stick with a little paper on it. Or you can just fade it to black.
Or I can just say bye.
Bye. Don't forget to subscribe!
And hit like!
I hate when I say that. It sounds so stupid.
And like and subscribe!
But it's better to say it in the end.
Yeah,
instead of the beginning. Like some people, if you like it, like. Mamba. Mamba. You're just like, I just stop.
We'll see. We'll see if I like it or not.
But okay, we are finished.
Yes.
So don't forget to check out Jessica. And our super long Get Ready With Me. Get Ready With Us, maybe it's called.
Yes.
And I feel sorry for you that you have to edit that.
It will be fun.
Yeah, it will be
maybe
fun.
It hasn't recorded anything.
Oh. You don't delete that now.
No, oh my god, I don't want to check.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Thanks, God. Yeah, okay, so I really hope you liked this video. Don't forget to check out Jessica, and I hope I will see you in the next one. Bye!